In this section, I will explain what pesticide residues are and how they change over time. I will also discuss how regulatory agencies, such as the Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, and the California Department of Pesticide Regulation, DPR, work to protect the public and the environment from pesticide exposure. When a pesticide is applied, pesticide residues are present even when you follow all label instructions properly. Pesticide residues are the traces of pesticide compounds that remain on or in the crop after they are applied. Pesticide residues decline as the pesticide breaks down over time, so the levels of residues are highest immediately after the application and diminish as the crop continues to grow. Pesticide residue levels remaining on the crop at the time of harvest must be below legal limits set by regulatory agencies. By the time the food reaches the grocery store or the processing plant, pesticides are expected to be far below legal limits. All pesticides pose some level of risk. As I mentioned in the first section, EPA must ensure that pesticides do not pose any unreasonable risks to human health or the environment. The basis for the regulation, sale, distribution, and use of pesticides in the United States is the Federal Insecticide, Fungicide, and Rodenticide Act, FIFRA, that authorizes EPA to review and register pesticides for specified uses. Before a pesticide is even approved for use on a specific crop, EPA makes an assessment to make sure it will not pose an unreasonable risk to humans or the environment. This is known as a risk assessment. Scientists study the effect of pesticides on non-target organisms, such as humans, wildlife, aquatic organisms, plants, bees, and other beneficial insects. They look at how the pesticides break down or move around in the environment in order to determine how they impact soil, water, and air quality after they have been applied. Although EPA uses the best science available when making decisions, the process of a risk assessment is not perfect because it can only work with the latest information available. Because of this, EPA is continually gathering information from people who report pesticide problems and reevaluating pesticides as new science becomes available. This process can lead to changes in the allowed uses of the pesticide or its removal from the market. Once EPA determines that a pesticide meets the necessary safety standards, a pesticide is approved for use. Key information gathered from the risk assessment determines the directions included on the pesticide label. These directions reflect the uses that were evaluated in the risk assessment process and determined to be unlikely to pose any unreasonable risks to non-target organisms and the environment. Before a pesticide can be used in California, it must also be evaluated and registered by DPR. The manufacturer must present test data to show the pesticide will not pose unacceptable risks to workers, consumers, or the environment. DPR also has the statutory authority to require full pesticide use reporting in California for commercial applications. California has the nation's toughest pesticide regulations and the largest and best trained pesticide enforcement organization to make sure the rules are followed. Remember, not all pesticides approved by EPA can be used in California. And California has more strict use requirements for certain pesticides than EPA. It is essential to always find and follow the most up-to-date pesticide label so you can be sure you are using the product as it was intended and in accordance with the most recent scientific findings and regulations. Following the pesticide label is the only way to prevent illegal pesticide residues.